Hello everyone, my name is Alessandro Tolo and today I will present to you our techniques that allows the digital fabrication of 3D shapes in a single block using 4-axis milling machines. Digital fabrication is a process that concerns the production of tangible objects from a digital model. Starting from input 3D representation of the shape, digital fabrication is composed of a processing phase in which algorithms perform to allow the fabrication, and a fabrication phase in which the object is physically produced. The most common technology for digital fabrication can be divided into two categories: additive manufacturing, like the widespread 3D printing technology, and subtractive manufacturing, like CNC machining. Subtractive manufacturing is based on the idea of cutting material away from a solid block. On the contrary, 3D printing constructs the object by adding material layer by layer. Subtractive manufacturing is usually faster and capable of producing objects of a wide range of materials. 3D printing, instead, is limited to particular materials that are usually more expensive. For this reason, subtractive manufacturing is the dominant process of the large-scale manufacturing. Subtractive manufacturing has strict geometry constraints that impose several limitations on the object that can be fabricated. In particular, traditional 3D-axis CNC machining requires the manufactured object to be a height-filled block with a flat base. Therefore, the fabrication of intricate shapes is not trivial, and it requires an expert of plan the fabrication. Hence, machines with more degrees of freedom have been designed to extend the class of shapes that are fabricable from subtractive manufacturing. 4-axis machines add to the traditional 3-axis a further rotation around one of the three axes, and 5-axis machines include two rotation axes. While 4-axis machine can be obtained by extending a three-axis machine with a rotation tool, 5-axis machines are usually very expensive and require complex planner. In the past years, considerable efforts have been made to allow the automatic fabrication of 3D shapes using CNC machines. However, this process may require the decomposition of the shape into multiple blocks that are fabricated and then assembled together. For example, the work of Montoni et al. Decomposed 3D shapes in a set of height-filled blocks with a flat base, which can be manufactured with the 3-axis CNC milling machine in a single pass. The HF slicer introduced the concept of double height field, blocks that can be manufactured in two machine phases, having opposite milling direction, leading to a small number of resulting blocks. Unlike these two works, our method aims to manufacture shape in a single block without any volume decomposition. To do so, we exploit the 4-axis, which extend a set of fabricable shapes. Other works perform surface decomposition to produce the object. Herold et al. Perform a surface segmentation in height-filled chart in order to perform mold casting. Instead, the S-Carver automatically plans and optimizes the different phases of rotation angle for the fabrication with the 5-axis milling machine. None of these methods exploit the 4-axis CNC machine for manufacturing. There exists main-of-the-shelf software package for 3-axis machining. In the standard pipeline, they take in as an input the model of the stock and the desired shape, and they give us output a toolpath. This is finally used by the CNC machines to fabricate the object. In this work, we use a 4-axis machine obtained by adding a 4-axis rotation support tool to a traditional 3-axis machine. This setup is not expensive and widely available in the market. The key idea of our method is to reduce the problem of 4-axis fabrication to multiple 3-axis machine passes from different directions obtained by rotation tool. We introduce a new pipeline for fabricating complex shapes in a single block without any visible seams, using 4-axis CNC machines. The key idea is to derive an optimal surface decomposition of the shape and then mill the object from the different directions that are orthogonal to the rotation tool. Then, Two three axis passes are performed to fabricate the region corresponding to where the blocks were secured to the region shaft. There are steps, a negative mold used to support the block in order to guarantee a proper alignment of the object during the fabrication. The pipeline consists in four main steps. In the first, we perform a pre-filtering that removes high frequency details from target model. Then we find an optimal rotation axis in which the block will be secured on the rotation shaft, partitioning the mesh in three distinct regions. The choice of the axis has a huge effect on the steps, the decomposition of the surface in height fields. Finally, we generate the models to be fabricated that can be processed by any of the shelf software for three axis CNC machine. Firstly, we remesh the input model to obtain a regular and uniform tessellation, and we remove the high frequency details by performing some iteration of Taubin smoothing. In this way, we sacrifice the exact fidelity to the input for a faster and more natural fabrication, since we avoid the decomposition in excessive number of charts. After the segmentation, the frequency detail will be reintroduced, enforcing the fabrication constraint. Note that this is optional and the number of iterations is interactively chosen by the user. The choice of the optimal rotation axis for the 4-axis machine has a massive impact on the quality of the final segmentation and the fabrication. We search among candidate direction samples on the Fibonacci sphere, finding the one which maximizes the overall fabrication accuracy. For a candidate rotation axis, we find the three regions, respectively top, side, and bottom. Top and bottom are height field determined by an iterative region growing from the extreme faces along the given direction and represent the region that will be fabricated by the three axis passes at the end of the process. The remaining portion of the mesh is called the side region and is composed of the surface which will be fabricated during the 4-axis process. Then, the optimal axis is determined by summing up a measure of the fabrication accuracy for each region, comparing the triangle normal with its possible fabrication direction using the given axis. Then, we derive a decomposition for the side region. In particular, we sample a set of uniformly generated fabrication direction orthogonal to the rotation axis, and we solve an optimization problem to assign a fabrication direction to each face using a graph cut approach. We minimize the sum of two cost terms. The first, the fidelity term, describes the cost of assigning a face to a fabrication direction. This term favors the assignment of a face to its optimal milling direction. We compute the visibility from a given direction, taking into account occlusions. If a face is visible, we assign a cost by considering how much the face normal are aligned with the milling direction, and we assign a height cost if the face is not visible. The smooth term describes the cost of assigning labels to two adjacent faces. It favors the formation of a limited number of compact and smooth patches with boundaries in areas with low geometrical details. If there are assigned the same labels, we have cost zero cost. Otherwise, we have a cost the sum of the two terms. The term C is called compactness. Low values of this parameter result in a segmentation with a high number of patches, while high values favor the formation of less charts at expense of the optimal alignment of the faces with the corresponding milling direction. The second term is composed of the average saliency of the two faces multiplied for a saliency factor d. Saliency gives a measure of geometrical detail of the mesh, so high value of d favors the formation of the boundaries in areas with low details. We compute the saliency with the approach proposed by Li et al., interpolating the values of the triangles. Then, for each face, we select the maximum value of the firing neighborhood and we perform a Laplacian smoothing on these values. Additionally, in our framework, the user can also select interactively the areas with height saliency. However, due to occlusion, the final segmentation may present small charts. We chose to remove them, iteratively assign the face to a surrounding labels, sacrificing the fidelity of the shape to have a more straightforward fabrication. The smoothness of the chart boundaries, however, plays a crucial role in a high-quality result. For this reason, we perform a Laplacian smoothing of the boundary lines, reprojecting the edge on the shape tangent space. At the first step of the pipeline, we can optionally remove the frequency detail of the shape. In case we perform this operation, we use the same approach in Montoni et al. For reintroducing the details, enforcing the height field constraint. The resulting shape is very close to the original one, with Hausdorff distance approaching zero. In the following images, we can see how the silency terms favors the formation of the boundaries in areas with low details, guaranteeing the high quality fabrication in the regions. After computing the segmentation, we now need to plan the manufacturing process in a sequence of 3-axis milling passes. For each chart, we have to generate the stock model and the target shape. However, it is not trivial to generate the target model to allow the fabrication of exclusively a chosen partition of the surface. To do so, we must embed each portion of the surface belong to each chart and to the given stock. The trivial solution of using parallel walls would lead to the collision of the drill bit, making it impossible to mill near the chart boundaries. Instead, we tilt these walls until they form a given angle, avoiding collision during the milling process. Note that in our example, we always use a cylinder as a stock in order to minimize the result size, even if other shapes are allowed. Obviously, each of these target models should not contain portion of the surface assigned to other chart. However, using tilted walls, this is not always possible. In the image, we show an example of this problem for chart 2. This would lead to erroneous removal of the sum volume that is highlighted in red, or its fabrication from a different direction that the one assigned. However, we can minimize the collision of the charts with the tilted walls. Indeed, if we fabricate C1 before C2, we won't have any collision. This leads to need of finding an ordering in the fabrication for the charts. We solve an optimization problem with a grid approach that minimizes the area that collides among the charts. Once we have found the fabrication sequence, we can generate the resulting models and stock for every fabrication direction. Note that we use each result as a stock for the next step in the sequence. The mesh are generated using exact Boolean operation. Here we show the resulting target models ready to be inserted in any software for 3-axis machining toolpath generation. We also generated the models for the 2 3-axis passes for the top and bottom regions. We also generated the mold for supporting the block during the last phase. The project has been developed in C++ and Qt using CG3Lib, VCGLib, SIGAL, LibIGL for geometry processing routines and HIGEN for linear algebra function. We generated the toolpath with Autodesk Fusion 360 and we performed the fabrication in StepCraft CNC milling machine. Here we show some results obtained with our method. From left to right, we show the input model, the silence information, the final segmentation and the manufacturer object. We fabricated 2 results in wood and 2 results in PVC, as we can see in this image. Due to limited size of our machine, we fabricated the result of maximum of 70 mm in height. The small size influences the fabrication quality, since the cutter cannot be thinner than 1 mm. However, we obtained a great result. The overall processing time always took a few minutes, while the entire fabrication took between 8 and 9 hours to each model. We also show some final segmentation of the model that we have not physically produced. The results are composed of a limited number of charts. Here we show some pictures of main fabrication phases of the kitten model. On the left, we show each pass of the said region. On the right, the fabrication of the top and bottom regions. At the end of the milling, a portion of the stock initially surrounding the shapes is let to save fabrication time, but with very thin connection. It may remain attached to it due to limitation or machine accuracy, especially for such small models, but we can easily remove it and polish the model afterward to obtain the final result. In this video, we show our machine during the actual fabrication of the Buddha model. We can see the fabrication of the extreme regions of the model. While the first region, the block can lean its in flat base, for the second, the support is used to secure and align the block. Our method fails when there is a considerably large portion of the shape which is not visible from any direction obtained by rotating the shaft. There is not a formal definition of the shape manufacturable in a single block using 4-axis milling machines, and it is not a trivial problem due to the many constraints involving the process. Anyway, as long as the shapes do not have a vast portion of the surface occluded from every direction, our method produces a segmentation that may be composed of the height number of the chart, but theoretically viable. These three images show a segmentation from different orientations. From four complex shapes, the segmentation can result in height number of chart, and the choice of the rotation axis has a height influence of the final output. In our results, some small portion could be not visible from the direction assigned, since the proposed method relies on heuristics and occlusion are not fully taken into account during the detailed restoration and the boundary smoothing. However, most of the software for toolpad generation automatically produces the closest fabricable shape. Finally, a tiny top and bottom regions would lead to the practical problems during the manufacturing, since they must be wide enough to support the entire block during the whole process. We introduced a novel automatic method for the fabrication of the non-regular shape in a single block using 4-axis subtracting machinery. Our result demonstrated that our approach allows to the fabrication of highly detailed models, even with a genus different from zero. We design our method so that it can fit within current industrial fabrication setting with minimal upgrades. We thus expect that our techniques can have immediate practical applications, possibly at an industrial level in small and medium enterprises. To boost the adoption of our method, we realize the source code with an open source license. It can be accessed on GitHub at this link. We can guarantee full reproducibility of all results shown in the paper and this presentation. Thanks for your attention.